Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of MongoDB, that is MongoDB 5 in your industrial operating system. And then I'll also show you how to use MongoDB in your MongoDB shell. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to use a very beautiful graphic user interface developed by MongoDB itself, that is this MongoDB compass. So, using that graphic user interface, you'll be able to use the entire features of MongoDB in a IDE. So I am going to, you know, also demonstrate that. So this video going to be a bit long. So what I'll be suggesting you to, you know, to watch the entire video to get the entire knowledge of MongoDB. So this is a proper starting tutorial, I would say. If you want to have some basic understanding of MongoDB and also know how to use MongoDB, then I'll be also suggesting you to watch this entire video. Right, so without any further ado, let's start our video. Now, to download and install MongoDB, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here, just simply type MongoDB download, then enter. And the first one is add, so I am just, you know, going to leave that over here. And if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this www.mongodb.com is basically our first search result. So now just click on MongoDB community download, and you can clearly see this official site of MongoDB has been, you know, rightly opened. I'll be also putting this link in the description, so you don't need to worry about the link and all. Right, and now in here you can clearly see under this available download sections, there are the version is 5.0.1. Now this is basically the current version, right? Depending upon what time you are downloading, you might see some other versions. Maybe that version would be modified one. So all you need to do is, you need to, you know, just, you know, simply keep this everything as default, and you need to also choose your operating system. Since I am using only Windows operating system, I am going to, you know, simply select this Windows operating system, and the package is MSI. So, you know, keep this all default and then just simply click on download to download our MongoDB. And now you can clearly see our MongoDB is now currently started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this MongoDB Windows 5.0.1 version has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, just, you know, simply double click on it. And you can clearly see our MongoDB Windows installer has been rightly prompted. Let us first minimize our download directory. So this is basically, you know, our installation wizard of MongoDB. To install, just, you know, simply click on next. And then you need to just simply accept this license agreement. If you have time, you can always read that. Right. And then just, you know, simply click on next. Now it's saying that what type of version you like to install. So this is a complete version and this is the custom version. Now I'm going to, you know, recommend you to install the complete version. So for that, all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply click on this complete. Yeah. And now under the service configuration, this install MongoDB as a service has been, you know, rightly checked, and this run service as a network service user, and then service name is set as a MongoDB, and this is going to be, you know, our data directory, and this is our log directory. So what I'll be suggesting you is just, you know, simply keep this everything as a default and then just simply click on next. Now it's, you know, ready to be installed. So just, you know, simply click on next for installation. And you need to just again simply click on install for installation. And this will, you know, going to start installing our MongoDB. You can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started. Now you need to just, you know, simply click on yes to provide administrative privileges. And you can clearly see our installation has been rightly started. It will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing MongoDB 5.0.1. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see our MongoDB has been rightly installed, and our MongoDB compass has also been started initializing. So all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply click on finish. And currently it's now loading our plugins. So welcome to MongoDB Compass. So just, you know, simply click on next. And again, simply click on next. So this is just an introduction. If you want to, you know, read, you can always read that. So what we'll be doing is, you know, just simply click on cancel. So now it's telling that some privacy settings. If you want to, you know, change anything, you can always do that. I'm going to, you know, just simply skip these steps. So just, you know, simply start using compass, right? Now just, you know, simply maximize it, and you can clearly see this is basically the interface of our MongoDB. In here, if you just simply click on this field in connection fields individually, you can clearly see that our host name is localhost, that is already given, and our port number is 27017. So now just simply keep this all default and then just simply click on connect. And you can clearly see we have rightly connected over our database. Right. Now, you know, I'm going to first show you how to use MongoDB form shell. So for that, all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply click on this command prompt, and in here just simply type mongo space dash dash version, then enter. But see, even after installation of Mongo, it is telling that Mongo is not recognized as an internal or an external command. So all this basically mean is your environment path is not set. So for that, what you need to do is you need to just simply go to your C directory, then go to program files, then go to MongoDB. In here, you'll be getting a server folder. So just go inside that folder, then go inside that 5.0 folder. And then you need to just simply go inside this bin folder. So just go inside that. And in here, if you just simply click on this address bar and then just, you know, simply right click on it and copy. Right. So you have rightly copied this address, that is where this Mongo is actually reside. In here, if you just simply click on the search icon, and in here just simply type environ, you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just, you know, simply click on that. And here you need to just simply click on environment variables. And now under this system variables, just simply click on path, right? And then you need to just simply click on edit. In here, you need to just, you know, simply click on new, and then just right click on it and paste. So you're basically going to paste this MongoDB server 5.0/bin path, and then just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK. And now if you just minimize this directory, and you need to first cancel this command prompt, and you need to just again open it. And now if you just simply type mongo space dash dash version, then enter, you can clearly see this Mongo shell version 5.0.1 has been, you know, rightly set. So you need to just simply set that environment path. That's a very important step. Many of the, you know, students just mistake that. They don't set the environment path. That's a very important step. So please do that. So that's why I just told, please do watch the entire video. So I'll be also recommending you to do the same still now. Right. So now that you know that our MongoDB shell has been rightly installed, so let us first check whether our MongoDB itself has been rightly installed or not. So for that, all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply type MongoD, just D, then space dash dash version, then enter. And then you can clearly see our DB has been, you know, also rightly installed, and our DB version is 5.0.1. So you just know that your Mongo shell and also MongoDB has been, you know, rightly installed. And now all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply start our shell, Mongo shell basically. So for that, what you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply type Mongo, right? This Mongo, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this prompt. So you can clearly see our MongoDB shell has been, you know, rightly opened over here. In here, if you just simply type show database, so that is show DBS, then semicolon and enter, to know that what are, you know, the database that are also coming by default. So you can clearly see this admin config local are has been, you know, rightly there as our database. So if you just go over here, you can clearly see this admin config and local has been, you know, also showing under this database name. So it's, you know, showing the same thing in our Mongo shell as well. So here, let's say you want to, you know, create a new database, what we'll do. So for that, what you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply type this use command. So use, and then you need to give a database name. So let's give a database name as MyDB. That's totally your wish. So use MyDB, then enter. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly telling that switch to DB MyDB. So now that you know our database MyDB has been directly created, all you need to do is simply create a new collection so that we can insert data in our database, right? So for that, what you need to do is simply type db dot your collection name. So let's give a collection name as playouts. That's totally your wish. Then we are basically going to do is we're going to simply insert. So for that, simply type insert. And then you need to know that in MongoDB we just store our data in JSON format, right? So for that, what you need to do is first give this insert as a method, and then inside that method you need to give two curly braces. So these two curly braces is mainly used for as a JSON format. So let's give the first name as an attribute. So first name, and let's give the first name as, let's say, Shourav. That is totally your wish. I'm going to give this first name as Shourav, then simply click on enter, and you can clearly see this right result has been prompt inserted one. So we have rightly inserted one data. Let's insert one more data. So this time let's insert another name. Let's insert Rahul. So all these my favorite cricketers, so I'm just giving that name only. So it has also rightly inserted. Right, now let's say you want to see how this collection is actually showing. So for that, what you need to do is simply type show then space collections then semicolon then enter, and you can clearly see our collection name is players. That is what we have defined. Right, now let's say you want to show the details as well. So for that, just simply type db dot then your collection name is players. So just simply type that and then dot and find, right? Then just give it like a method, and then just simply click on enter, and you can clearly see our first name Shourav and Rahul has been rightly shown in our console. So this is the two name that we have inserted, and they have given a proper object ID, which is basically unique to all, right? And let's say you want to check all databases. So for that, you need to just again simply type show DBs then semicolon and enter. You can clearly see this MyDB has been created over here, right? So in this way you install MongoDB, and I have also shown you how to use this MongoDB shell. Now let's move on to our MongoDB compass. Now in here, let's say you want to create a new database. So for that, it's very simple. Just simply click on this create database, and in here you need to give a database name. So this time let's give a database name as a TasteDB, and give the collection name. Remember, the collection name that we have given there is players. So this time let's give a collection name as students, and keep everything as a default, and then just simply click on create database, and you can clearly see our TasteDB has been actually created over here. And previously, remember, we have also created this MyDB. So this MyDB, that is, we have created in our using our shell, and I am now going to show you how we can use our MongoDB compass. So you can clearly see this TasteDB has been rightly created over this MongoDB compass. Now you need to just simply go inside this TasteDB to insert any data as and all. So you have this collection name is students. So just simply go inside that. And in here, let's say you want to insert any data. You can always import data from any JSON or CSV file. So for that, you need to just simply click on import data, and you can easily import any data in JSON and CSV file format. But this time I am going to just simply show you how you can manually insert data. So for that, what you need to do is just simply click on this drop down icon, and then in here just simply select this insert document, right? And then you'll be seeing this pop-up that is insert to collection TasteDB.students. Remember this collection that we have created, and our database name is TasteDB, right? In here, you need to just simply click on this icon, and in here, just simply hover over this one, and you'll be getting this plus icon. So just simply click on that, and then you need to just simply click on add field after ID. And then you'll be seeing an option where you can easily write over here. So this time let's give attribute name as name only. Right. And then just simply click on tab, and in here you can write your name. So let's give a name as Yuvraj, and then just, you know, simply click on insert, and you can clearly see our name Yuvraj has been, you know, rightly inserted under this ID, object ID, right? Let's say you want to edit this name. So for that you need to just simply click on this icon, and you can easily edit this name. Let's say you want to edit this name to Gautam. So just, you know, simply type that much, and then just simply click on update, and you can clearly see this name has been, you know, rightly updated over here. Similarly, if you wish to, you know, just simply delete this data, you can easily do that by simply clicking on this delete icon. So just, you know, simply click that, and then just simply click on delete, and it will, you know, rightly going to be deleted. And this time, since we have no data, so it will, you know, just show this collection has no data. You can always, you know, insert the same way. And as I have shown, you can always import a file, right? So in this way, you install our MongoDB compass. I have rightly shown you how to install MongoDB, and then I have also shown you how to set environment path and all. And after that, I have shown you how to use this MongoDB shell, and I have also shown you how to use MongoDB compass, right? So that's basically all about this video. Please do share with your friends. This really motivates me to make more such videos. And also please do put a comment in our comment sections if you wish to, you know, get more videos on MongoDB. So this really is going to make me motivated to make more videos on MongoDB. So please do mention that in our comment sections if you really wish that. And that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you.